family moseyed over to the Kiji Chapel. And lucky for me, I was able to see it when the Kiji Chapel didn't look like it was still a part of the movie set and the crew forgot to take off the props. Now, I don't know if the chapel is in real need of repair, or the church is trying to discourage the onslaught of Angels and Demons fans in large tour groups from hoarding the chapel. Anyway, according to the Angels and Demons novel, the Kiji Chapel is Santi's earthly tomb, covered in pagan and apparently Illuminati symbols, including the demon hall, which, as it turned out, wasn't inside the pantheon after all. This was a private mortuary chapel belonging to Agostino Kiji, a prominent banker from Siena with more money than the Pope. He was also a generous patron of Renaissance art, as well as the patron of Raphael, whom he commissioned to design his chapel. Unfortunately, both patron and artist died before the chapel was even completed, and so the work was passed on to Gian Lorenzo Bernini by his patron, Fabio Kiji, who is Agostino's great-grandson, who also became Pope Alexander VII. And so, the chapel was completed a century after Raphael's death. The work attributed to Raphael, like the mosaics and the statues of Jonas and Elijah, were done by other artists based on his cartoons and sketches. The two pyramids, monuments to Agostino Kiji and his brother Sigismondo, as well as the statues of Prophet Habakkuk and the angel, as well as Prophet Daniel, were created by Bernini. If you look above, you'll notice a spectacular dome reminiscent of the one in St. Peter's, but at a much smaller scale. And it's really got a lot going on. There are four painted medallions of the allegories of the seasons. And from Raphael's drawings, mosaics representing the creation of the world surrounded by the sun and seven classical planets, each moved by an angel. In the center of the dome is a mosaic of God in the act of creating, which also resembles the creation fresco in the Sistine Chapel by Michelangelo. On the floor beneath the dome is a creepy skeleton manhole with an inscription that reads, Mors ad Caelos, which loosely translates to something like, from death to heaven.
The Kiji Chapel was
Kiji.
Made very famous by Dan Brown.
The Angels and Demons.
Yes. Have people been asking you about that?
Many people.
So what do you tell them?
It's a fantasy, because I didn't read the book, but other person that work with me that have to read this book told me that there is no real parallel. Also, many things are just invented to obtain a purpose.
To make the story interesting, yes.
Yes, okay. It's so interesting. Yes, it's true that the Kiji Chapel is full of symbols and many strange things. For example, in the dome, with God at the center and allegory of the seven planets all around. Seven planets are pagan gods. So pagan gods with God, the Christian God, is not typical parallel. So in this chapel, it's possible to see this thing, because the property of the chapel was of Agostino Kiji, that is the person that is buried in the right pyramid. And he was very addicted to astronomy and so on, so he believed in the power of fortune, of the stars and of the planets above our lives. So he tried to reconstruct in this chapel this kind of philosophy that he had. But he knew that our soul, when the body is dead, only the soul is still alive, because he was a Christian, and the soul has to go again to God. So there is a special mix between these two cultures, pagan and Christian, what is linked to Agostino Kiji and his philosophy. Also under the chapel, under the hall, the Bernini Hall, and under there is nothing.
There's something was there before?
Yes, the bones of the Kiji that now are moved. But it's a closed area, there is no passage and so on.
Interesting. And that's another one with the lion?
This is another one.
This is so elaborate.
Yes, because it's Rococo. It's the Baroque, so it's the best of Baroque. It's opulent.
Very.
And the noble woman that is in the circle is Maria Flaminia Odescalchi. The symbol of the family was the lion and the eagle. Mm. That is linked with another symbol of another family, that is the Chigi family, the sixth hill of Siena, and the tree that is a symbol of another family. So all symbols of many families that are all linked one to the other.
Oh, beautiful piece.
And this is another particular significance of that. This is a red curtain. It's like the fire of the life that is red. But when you are dead, it's freezed.
The fire just froze in place like a statue.
Frozen, yes. And so all the curtain goes on your life.
It goes down.
Goes down on your life.
Like the end of the theater, the curtain
the
goes down,
yes.
The end of the show.
End of the show.
No encore.
No. Little angels, also this angel is very particular. Any angels announce that the trumpet of death. One another symbol of death is the snake.
Oh, the snake biting his tail. Mm-hmm. It's in a circle.
It's a particular symbol of regeneration, of rebirth.
The cycle of life.
Yes.
This church is very symbolic.
It's full of symbols. Number 8. Is the number of eternal life.
Oh yeah, because when you turn it sideways, yes, it's a sign of eternity.
And also, if you know about the 7 days of the creation, the creation was made by God in 7 days, so a day more is the day of the life after life.
The eternal life.
The eternal life. And this church, if you look, there is many 8.
Oh.
Four chapel in that nave, chapel in this other nave, so 8.
8. Yeah. These columns pillars.
Are 8 elements. And also the Chigi chapel is octagonal.
Not all of them, though, just the Chigi chapel.
Chapel and this dome with the octagonal.
Oh, okay. Interesting.